Hi, this is an educational video about coronavirus which causes COVID-19 disease. Let's educate ourselves about what is COVID-19, its history including its origin and spread, how it is being controlled and prevented, what is its economic cost, what different countries are doing about it, what are the possible ways out of this, and lastly, how far the researchers are in developing a vaccine for coronavirus. COVID-19 is the disease known as coronavirus disease, which came from a new species of virus known as novel coronavirus. This virus attaches itself to human cells through glycoproteins. Coronaviruses are a family of viruses that range from common cold to SARS to MERS. However, this coronavirus causing COVID-19 is less deadly but more infectious. The most common symptoms of coronavirus disease include fever, tiredness, and dry cough. This coronavirus was first identified in December 19 in Wuhan, China. It is thought to have come from bats. Popular theory is that this coronavirus originated from bats and then moved to humans through pangolins or other animals. The coronavirus spread from China to other countries through international travel. Now, let's see how each country got infected through a chart. The confirmed cases of coronavirus started rising in other countries in early February. After China, South Korea started reporting rise in early March. By this time, China succeeded in controlling the new infections through strict lockdowns. By the middle of March, Italy reported exponential rise in infections. The last week of March marked Italy as highest number of infections, with quickly US catching up. US quickly crossed Italy as highest number of infections. Now the top three countries with most cases are US, Spain, and Italy. The coronavirus spread from China to other countries and from Asia to Europe and US. Now the hotspot is US, with highest number of single day deaths caused by coronavirus since its emergence in China in December. The countries have resorted to lockdowns and social distancing to control the spread of this coronavirus disease. The lockdowns are now global, with people going out only for necessities. Another measure is social distancing. This helps in reducing the chances of infections by reducing contact. With social distancing, less number of people are likely to be affected. The lockdowns and social distancing are helpful in flattening the curve, which aims to reduce the number of people needing healthcare facilities at the same time. The control and prevention measures seem to be working, as China, South Korea, Japan, and other countries have slowed down the COVID-19 spread. But the lockdowns have steep economic cost. The coronavirus is expected to reduce the global income by $1 to $2 trillion and reduce the global growth rate by 2.5%, which is a threshold for recession. The heavy economic impact have left countries and international organizations scrambling for ways to reduce recessionary pressures. Various countries have announced packages for economic stimulus, with US and China leading the way. However, poor countries cannot afford these huge investments because of low reserves and heavy debts. So the easiest thing is quickly going out of this disaster. There are three possible ways of getting out. One way is that we develop a vaccine quickly and somehow deliver it globally. However, it may take anywhere from 6 months 2 years. Our economies and society may not survive this long. Another way is that we let everybody out and build herd immunity. It means the people will quickly get exposed, majority of them will recover, and eventually the disease will stop spreading. But this herd immunity strategy may cost a lot of human lives. Anywhere from 2 to 20% of infected people may die, killing between 160 million to 1.6 billion people. It will also put a lot of pressure on human health systems, which they may not be able to bear. So this option is pretty much out of the window. The last way is to adapt ourselves quickly. Let the people who have been exposed and developed immunity carry out economic activities. Also open the activities for healthy people with least chances of fatality. The people with less than 50 years of age have lower fertility rate, although the evidence is still limited. And if the disease starts spreading, then we'll quickly shut down and open again. As of today, there is no vaccine available. Various trials are in process though. More than 60 teams are working according to World Health Organization. The quickest promises have come from Oxford University, which is still 8 months away. Second quickest is from Inovio Pharmaceuticals. It will take between 1 year to 18 months. Thank you for your time. Stay home and stay safe.